actually. Boom! Yeah.
The lead out?
Yep.
So Halsey, the three parts of the swing are, you're gonna go ahead and get on the rope, yep. And I'll try to work with you. You get on that back foot and there's a strong stride, right?
That's correct. Yep.
You push yourself like a speed skater, correct?
Yep.
Let's see that once. Okay? And secondly, the main bread and butter you've always told me of your swing is you have a lead arm motion that's driven off that hip rotation. How would you refer to that?
Well, it's more of a stab, a punch. It's got to be forceful, you know. And if people watch my swing, it's very forceful.
There's a lot of tricep extension.
Exactly.
And there's actually lat and bench press muscles that take that off your chest, right?
Correct.
And that actually, the nice thing about the rope, it sets kind of a proper plane, doesn't it?
Yes. Yep. This is actually a perfect little device if you're trying to train here, because you can see from my step, boom, from the explosion, boom, and then the third part of it is just the snap.
You turning 50, you hit as phenomenally well as I've ever seen you in the last 20 years I've known you last night here, and these two things are really what the main gist of your swing is?
Well, I think it's a combination of all three. I think like we've always talked about, Bogey, is that stride, is that push here. I build so much torque up on the bottom half and pushing off, and then like you've always said, and we've done these videos for years, is this top hand here is so forceful, and like you said, it's more of a jab, more of a stab. And then the third part of it is, as soon as you make that stab, your hands are pushing and going through the zone and letting the bat do the work.
Do you actually even think of what the top arm does?
I don't think about it because it's natural for me, but I try to tell people and teach people, when you're gripping a bat, you know, one thing about me is when I grip a bat, I don't grip it like this because I can't break my wrist, but when I got my wrist here, I can break them through the zone. So that's the reason I tell everybody it's very important so you can snap. I call it a snap. So you got a push, a hit here, and then that snap. So
this extension, go ahead and grab this apparatus again, Halsey.
Yep.
Snap. That extension and rotation really drive that lead arm forward, creating lag, right?
Lag. And let me demonstrate a couple here for you. So if I'm sitting here.
We're about 15 minutes out from the 3 o'clock open game. Here. Reds on first, blues on third. We'll also be doing an outfield clinic over on field three at the same time.
It's simple. It's not that hard. This device here is a great tool for keeping your hands where they should be, coming through the zone like everybody's always taught you to go through the zone. And then here's the snap and release point. And then bam, you're extended, released. Now,
and the other thing that's interesting is this lead arm, get back in that start position. Yep. This lead arm, the extension is more tricep extension and arm extension.
Correct.
I mean chest extension. Getting the arm off the chest. I go ahead and do that arm extension again there.
Okay.
All right. But now when we add the top hand to it, go as far as the lead arm can go before the top hand. Right here, right at this point here.
Yep.
You've come off your chest, this tricep is extended.
Yep.
But this arm is still bent, so the top arm extension throws people off because it's actually a lot different than the lead arm extension. Because all you're going to do is straighten out that arm, and that continues to push it through.
Yep, and right there is your snap.
Do you ever really feel the top arm extend, or does that just follow the explosive movement of your lead arm?
I'll be honest, I don't necessarily concentrate on it, and
you've never said you have. You always said top arm is a guide that's along for a ride.
I've always used this as a guide. You know, it's a guide, but I also know that when I'm making a hard aggressive swing in the box, I also know that this hand is critical upon contact, impact, so I can push. And I tell everybody to break your wrist upon hitting. As soon as you hit, you're snapping those wrists and letting the bat do the work.
And you gotta be careful when we say that, Halsey, because the extension is what actually breaks the wrist.
That's correct.
You know, the wrists have to be strong to guide it a little bit, but you just don't torque the wrist. The arm extension, the top arm blown past the bottom.
That top arm is what you got to have.
But again, I think the point that I really liked, and yesterday you were so explosive from that left side, that if you really explode that front side, the top side's gonna fall pretty much automatically.
Hands down.
Yep.
And this device here is I know you've come up with a lot of cool things in the past, But this device here, I absolutely love it. I'd love to have this set up here in my batting cages as well, because this is a good device for anybody, a kid to, you know, 70, 80 years old can come in here and really use this device and feel exactly, because if you take this device and go through it just like I did, top hands here, and you go through this, that tells you and showing you how your arm should be up on impact. A lot of people get in here and they do this and then they get extension. You got to get in here, get extended out here. That's the point of contact is getting that ball hit out here and getting it extended.
And I'm telling you,
there's not been a better device that I've had for that, that good extension. And that's what you preach, Bogey. That's what I preach too, is that extension.
What we see in a lot of hitters attempt to drag the knob up in the air is they're creating a lag and stab on the proper path and the follow through. They're letting their rotation overpower the linear motion of driving the hands forward and creating a good snap. So what this does, it keeps you on the straight path. It keeps you the lag on the proper path, getting a good arm extension. And really, arm extension itself, when you don't extend your arms from the very start in a linear manner, you'll tend to rotate and drag off because the rotation is so powerful. Coming back from my back surgery 2.5 years ago, I found that I thought my rotation was weak, and really struggling to get back to form. I'm hitting good this winter, feeling better, rehabbing. And I'm finding that I have to feel a lot more linear in this creation of a extension of lag. And when this hand can go no farther on the stab without veering off, the top hand just finishes through impact and all the way to full extension. So the swing simulator is phenomenal for doing that. It gets you on the right hand path. Again, ba-boom. You can work on going right to the point of impact if you want. Ba-boom. And then you can also work on getting all the way through. Boom. And the nice thing about it is you can work with lower pitches. Say if I get a pitch that's waist high, I can go ahead and set the swing simulator down to emulate the path of where the ball is. If I have a lower pitch and I'm starting up here, my body angle is going to be back, and my lag to snap, you'll always see on most swings, is level, maybe slightly up on the higher pitches. But my hand path can't be that way. I think that's another reason why people get the notion that they should drag, because they feel like they have to swing up. As soon as your knob comes up, the bat head drops and you end up golfing and hitting the pitch. So if I have a ball that's down here, this is about belly button high, what I need to do on a lower pitch is I need to take my hand path down to the ball. Not necessarily the knob, because sometimes the knob will turn and the hand will be facing to the inside. I want to take my hands down towards the ball, create a nice lag. And when this arm can't go any further without veering off, the top hand finishes through to good impact and follow through. So that's where the trainer works really well. I can not only just use it as a slide tube to go ahead and create a hand path that's going to be towards the part of the ball I want to attack, but if I want to get all the way through it, I can go ahead and go ba, boom. I get the point where I make contact and get all the way through. So if you're interested in purchasing this, my wife Mary is making them, and we're selling them off the website. All you have to do is PayPal for family and friends, so that to that point we'll get it shipped right out for you. Phenomenal piece of equipment. Has been one of the best training tools and training aids we have for developing a lag and a proper arm extension driven by the throwing open of the hips. We've got your Cuz U-Trip bat in St. Pete. We're going to use it for our campers to demo it, and Brett's going to do a review on it when it comes to January. But what I like about that bat is you've got a very innovative device on it. What's that?
Yeah, it's the step down. We call it the step down cone for your hand here. You know how a lot of guys has got the
absolutely.
I don't see none around here, but you've got that little cone. People put tape. I've always used to put tape on the end of my bat. Well, now with this technology that they've got out, it's a step down end is what it is.
And you don't have to buy a $5 knob cuff.
There you go.
If they want to send that $5 directly to you, can they? You know, out of goodwill?
Yeah. But this, hey, listen, the technology on these bats, this is our... this was my first bat that we came out with for Louisville Slugger, the Z1000. And since then, we've come out with two other ones. One released in June, and now one just released 2 weeks ago prior to the camp, which is the new Cuz Edition model. And it has the new knob cuff on it, so it's nice, it's sweet. Our line of bats are going places, and what I'm excited about is we're at this senior camp And the good news is I just hit that mark to where I can start playing senior ball, and the technology we're putting into it, myself, DT from Louisville Slugger, working closely with the Innovation Center in Sacramento, California, is we're designing a senior bat that we're hoping to release by June of 2019. And if all you guys out there that know me, that swung my bats through the years, know one thing: if I'm gonna put my name on something, the technology's got to be there. And that's one thing I'm excited about, is we are taking the senior bat with Louisville Slugger, and we're gonna make something out of it, and I'm excited about it.